the void, but somehow different this time. I can pull you into this place. The outsider marked me long ago. I made you flee your precious tower and turned your father into cold stone. How difficult for you. But when I was young, sweet Jessamine and I were closest sisters, sharing a secret. Emperor Caldwin had another daughter, born in shame to a kitchen maid. Am I dreaming? If not, how is Delilah doing this? Go back to the servants' quarters to cockroaches and thin gruel. Emperor Daddy would visit and tell me if I was good. Next year I'd be old enough to come to court to be a princess. Then one day, pretty Jessamine broke something worth a fortune, and the spymaster caught us. She claimed I did it, and he whipped me in the garden house until I bled. My mother lost her kitchen job, and that night we were out on the streets with no place to sleep.
I didn't break it.
Would you like to tell me what did?
We were just playing.
Never mind, Jessamine. What's your name?
It was her. Delilah's light. She broke it.
Saw the nastiest parts of Dunwall, ending up in debtor's prison. Jessamine died quick on an assassin's blade, but my mother lingered for weeks after a fat guard broke her jaw. They threw me out when she died. I looked up at the lights of Dunwall Tower and swore revenge. Washing bedsheets in a brothel, I painted on the side, until Anton Sokolov took me as a student. That's the polite word for it. I was crafty even before the outsider marked me, and survived the worst the Empire could offer. Now, it's your turn.
My mother's sick. She needs help.
Your mother kicked off while you were out begging. She's another bag of bones now, girl.
What? No!
Your sentence is served and you'll be tossed out with the others. You can't stay here anymore.
Know whether my dear old aunt is telling the truth or not.
When I was young, The loyalist conspiracy that kidnapped me also took Anton Sokolov. They brought him to the pub where I was being held and locked him in a cage meant for dogs. And you know what? Sokolov laughed at them. He taught me lessons and told me funny stories. He seemed immortal. His mind shaped our age. That's changed. The old man I rescued doesn't talk much. He eats what we give him, groans in his sleep, coughs out blood. I thought he'd tell me the secret to defeating Delilah and saving the Empire. But I'm not even sure he knows where he is. Wasn't a dream, was it?
Am I to blame for Delilah's bitterness?
No. She's the one who orchestrated the coup.
Our decisions have weight. I feel my time drawing to an end. Soon. Push out into the harsh world. You are alone, but for a few allies.
Either way, you're back now. I'm glad.
Why
his age, Sokolov's making better progress than I would have expected.
Good to see you're still with us. Thank you for helping, Anton.
Sokolov's not the only one making a rapid recovery. I'll be good enough to leave soon. There's a lot to do. Of course, unless the Duke falls, he'll undo my best efforts here.
Then we'll have to make sure Duke Luca Abel doesn't overstay his welcome.
Karnaca's key leaders are flawed, for certain. After all this is settled with the Duke, and the time of the coup has passed. Whichever ones are left standing could change things here. Consider that, as you come face to face with the Duke's remaining associates.
I appreciate your thoughts on the matter, Alexandria.
I wish there was something I could remember to help in your efforts. Megan is worried that someone will see us coming and going. I might depart soon. Anton and I are both in your debt. Medicinal supplies are low. I might have to go out for extract of blood ox liver and some leche thistle seeds.
Emily.
The Empress has risen. A peaceful sleep, I hope. Nothing like the pillows at Dunwall Tower, made of goose feathers.
Sit down when you want to talk.
Jindosh won't be making his army of clockwork soldiers. Conservatory. This place was commissioned by my grandfather in my grandmother's name. One of the more elaborate structures in Karnaca, closed to the public. More of the Duke's questionable rulership. Delilah Copperspoon, or is it Caldwin? Anton. When I brought you back, you could barely speak. But it's been 3 days.
They tortured him. His body is covered with bruises.
Delilah has the throne, and my father is... missing. This is Anton Sokolov, the greatest mind in the Empire.
No, Emily. Megan is right. I can make electricity move from one side of the room to the other, but Delilah is beyond my understanding. When I came to Cirkonos, I meant to leave everything behind. But when the assassination started, I couldn't ignore it. By the time Megan and I connected the murders to the Duke, it was too late. The Crown Killer came for me. It kept me alive from my knowledge, but I saw things. Jindosh often had a visitor, Brianna Ashworth.
She's the curator of the Royal Conservatory.
Yes, Ashworth is dangerous, as obsessed with the occult as Delilah. Apparently, she's working on a device called the Oraculum.
There's more to her than either of you know.
If Ashworth is one of Delilah's lieutenants, I need to eliminate her. Who knows what this device is capable of, or what she's up to.
There's a spark in your eyes. Something other than hate, which surprises me given all that's happened. Maybe I should begin a series of Bloodfly-related sketches, infested corpses and the like. I've never paid a visit to the Royal Conservatory, but allegedly it has a number of unique pieces. The familiar creaks and groans of the dreadful wail. I lie awake listening, just to remind myself I'm safe again.
Meet me at the skiff when you want to set out for the Royal Conservatory. Ashworth has an interest in the occult. That's a snotty way to put it. In another life, you might be facing me along with her.
Head to the skiff when you're ready, Empress.
Delilah's cult must be thrilled she's got the throne. But she wouldn't piss on them if they were on fire. We'll take the skiff. I don't want to bring the dreadful whale any closer than we have to. There is a small dock in Syria Gardens, close to the conservatory. That's as far as I can take you. Ready to go?
Yes, let's go.
There'll be a grand guard presence outside the Royal Conservatory. Inside, be prepared for anything. Ashworth runs with an eclectic crowd. They'll be the real danger.
Someday I'd like to know more about how you met Ashworth.
I know you would. Trust me, Ashworth is important to Delilah. Which brings up something else. You might be able to exploit the Abbey of the Everyman in removing Ashworth from play. Turns out the Vice Overseer in Karnaca has been watching Ashworth from a hidden outpost near the Royal Conservatory. Check it out first if you want more options. Remember, if she's still working with Delilah, Ashworth is a grave threat.
Thanks, Megan. See you soon.
Why cover your face? Are you worried someone might recognize you?
I used to work in the mines. Don't recommend it. I got no kids, no wife, neither. There was a girl once. She left.
Go away. You've been warned. Get out of my face. You again. I don't like your face, but I can fix it. What do you want? Step back. Don't get any closer.
I'm the first one to admit when I'm scared. And there, I said it. I'm scared.
Hard times under the Duke and his grand guard. A man has to be ready for anything.
Just once, I'd like to see her buy the drinks. Just one time. Is that too much to ask?
The reason I did it, well, I can't really tell you right now. But stick around eventually, you'll find out.
If I see anything, I'll run. No. First, I'll yell, then
I told her once, I told her 1,000 times. It ain't my job to check on the grinders. Sometimes I think she's deaf on purpose.
Get out of my face.
Are disgusting this year, and what's next? It's enough to make a man.
I need new boots. Just don't fit right.
If that was nothing, then I'm a filthy blood fly, and that's all I'm gonna say about it.
Without a leg? That's what. Nothing. I wonder if the rumors are true about
Speak
looking for someone grabbing people off the street. What do they want? Hopefully they just leave me.
What's going on here?
You saw something?
Where'd you disappear to?
Welcome. Obviously, you are someone with refined tastes. Welcome to my shop. Say, an acquaintance of mine is supposed to be holed up in an office overlooking the Royal Conservatory. Check on them if you're headed that way. I check myself, but the streets are locked down. I'd make it worth your time.
I'll think about it.
See anything you like? What a pleasant surprise to see you again. Certain you will be satisfied with your purchase. No need to wrap it for you, I suppose. All those valuable artworks locked up in the conservatory where no one can see them. Truly an excellent choice. This is what I have for upgrading your equipment. Farewell, and do think of us again. What a pleasant surprise to see you again. The district is so quiet since the conservatory was closed. Welcome back. Please, take your time. Come in, my friend. Always a delight to see you.
That is worth a fortune.
Come back here!
What's going on here?
Shit! Lost.
You don't stand a chance anyway.
Holy shit! At last!
Oh, shit! She won't go anywhere!
Won't get away!
I bet you've been living a soft life. Come on! No use running! I'll cut
you
in half!
Hiding your face?
You shouldn't have wandered outside without bodyguards! Move!
No locker before coming out. Last time I left it open, someone left a hagfish in my jacket pocket.
hunch.
Who opened this door? Maybe the wind or something.
Some help over here!
So let's see.
Anna Ashworth, curator of the Royal Conservatory. For a while, I believed Ashworth has some connection to the occult in Karnaka. Something is happening that I don't understand. The overseers are the forward face of the Abbey, but equally important are our sisters from the Oracular Order. To be direct, I suspect something is wrong within their sect. Subtle changes to the types of proclamations they've been making. Small but troubling deviations from tradition. But publicly saying anything along those lines will get me accused of heresy by my rivals within the Abbey. Is it possible that Ashworth has infiltrated the Oracular Order?
So Vice Overseer Byrne thinks Ashworth is interfering with the Oracular Order. If true, it's another reason she has to be eliminated.
smells like piss. What a dump.
I'm hungry.
I'll find you, you know. Shit! What was that? Imagine that? No, I'm sure. I wonder what I'm dealing with.
was 6-3? Next time, I'll try it with a waxing gibbous. If she doesn't do it, then I've got no idea. I'm the favorite. And why not? falls apart.
To bring me something? The silver cigarette case, like we agreed?
No, listen. I can't go on doing this. Stealing for you. I'll lose my job.
Do you want to be a servant all your life? You're always talking about leaving Karnaca on a big white boat, never to come back. You spend your days polishing silver cutlery. Come with me, Beatrix. Let's leave.
Could we really get passage on a ship? What if they find us?
You know I'll protect you. Just like when we were kids.
I'll think about it. I promise.
What's that?
Am I seeing things?
Brothers of my blood.
It's looking right inside me.
This is the Duke. You must all know my voice by now. A new empress sits on the throne in Dunkirk. Our rightful ruler, Delilah Caldwin.
Help me!
Her
someone! Anyone!
Forever.
That's not right!
Traitors,
question
claim.
Guard! Someone!
Orly.
We'll give it to them, no matter how many of you I have to sacrifice. Draconis will fight for Delilah to the bitter end.
I told her 1,000 times. It ain't my job to check out the grinder. Sometimes I think she's different. Now they say there's someone on the prowl.
Workers, and he did it. No questions, no complaints.
Harnaka needed
miners.
Wait here. Just checking something. Stay here.
I'll just check what that was.
I wonder who that was.
Thank you. across this shuddering city. Brianna Ashworth would have been miserable as a member of high society, forced to win some bloated banker. Her only moments of real freedom, getting drunk at fancy balls, and slipping away to couple with strangers. It would have ended in an unhappy marriage and a late-night plunge into an icy river. But just before mother and father married her off, so many years ago, she found Delilah instead. It was all highways and graveyards after that, never looking back. Vice Overseer Byrne is an ambitious man, but he believes in the Abbey's mission, protecting the good people of the Empire against the likes of us. You know he'd be happier deep down if this ended with Brianna Ashworth's head on a spike. Maybe yours as well.
Air feels heavy. Hard to get a good lungful.
Reach out into the harsh world. You are alone, but for a few allies. One hand was busy pressing his head into her bosom, while the other was removing the bills from his wallet.
Sees the surprise I left for him, idiot.
Nasty sometimes. It flows from the fountain to the conservatory basement. There was work being done, so there's a grate missing. Maybe some animal crawled in there and died.
Disgusting. You'd think someone inside the conservatory would complain.
So the place is mostly shut. Somebody's still inside. There was a delivery from Jindosh Clockworks a few days back.
Whatever they're doing, I'd be happier if the gate wasn't so close to that fountain.
Disfigured. Blood flying nests all around them. Horrible.
Hey, where do you...
A shot. Something unsavory going on. I'm getting good and drunk after this.
Anyone here? Show yourself.
Not in the mood. Show yourself.
Thank you.
The Royal Conservatory. What do those walls hide?
This wool, it itches like mad. Why can't I wear my regular clothes?
Did I close my locker before coming out? Last time I left it open, someone left a hangfish in my jacket pocket.
What's that?
Wait.
Not this time.
Let's have a fair fight. Can't stay hidden forever. Search the whole place. I don't have time for that.
What's happened? Could be anything. I just gotta...
Who's running around over there?